Let me walk you through the new Figma AI features from Config 2025 and why two of them in particular might seriously change how we build digital products. So here's everything Figma launched. First, there's Figma Draw, a whole new set of tools for visual expression. You've got lasso, brushes, shape builder, text on paths, new fills and strokes. It's clearly aimed at illustrators and folks who live in the vector world. Cool update, but not the main event for product teams. Then they announced Grid, a new auto layout option that actually makes building responsive layouts in Figma feel like working with real CSS. You can span across multiple columns, define fixed track sizes, and align everything in cleanly with dev mode. Honestly, long overdue. They also launched Figma Buzz, which helps teams create on-brand assets at scale. Think marketing use cases, template libraries, restricted editing, AI-powered image generation, bulk assets creation, and a solid upgrade for brand consistency across large teams. But let's talk about the two features that actually shift the workflow, Figma Sites and Figma Make. Figma Sites lets you take your designs and push them straight to the web, not as a prototype, a live functional website. You can copy designs from Figma, choose from 50 templates, drag in blocks and assets, and set up breakpoints and interactions, marquee, product scroll, you name it. And then just hit publish, just like that. For early stage teams or solo builders, this cuts the time from concept to something real. No handoff, no stitching together Figma and Webflow or Framer. Just design, ship. Now let's talk about Figma Make. This one's wild. You paste in a design or type a prompt, and Figma generates a high-fidelity prototype backed by actual code. You can fine-tune it directly, change images, padding, margins, or jump into the code if you want. And yes, you can publish it as a live web app. It's not replacing developers, and the output isn't ready to scale, but it's not the point. What it does is delay the need for developers just long enough to validate ideas faster in native format. Instead of designing a static mockup and guessing how it's gonna feel, you just build it and test it. Now sure, there are skeptics. People saying the code is not good enough, there's still need to rebuild it anyway. And yeah, they're not wrong, but they're also missing the shift. This isn't about skipping steps, it's about getting to clarity sooner. You're not removing the developer, you're just buying time to validate idea properly before you waste resources on it. At Eleken, we're already seeing this trend. A few years ago, we designed everything from scratch. Now we mostly redesign MVPs that already found product market fit but need proper UX to grow. But they will help you move faster, test smarter, and bridge that messy gap between idea and working thing. And Figma isn't just adding features, they are folding entire categories in one ecosystem. Design, prototype, build, and test without switching platforms. If that changes how you think about the workflow, you're not alone. Let me know what you're most excited or skeptical about. Drop a comment, like, and subscribe for more honest takes on where product design is going next. See you in the next one.